Hello everyone, it's Chris the Batman Statue Collector, your Dark Knight of Collecting, and I'm back with kind of a brief statue chat today. I just wanted to talk to you a little bit about some things going on in the Batcave, and we just wrapped up Thanksgiving weekend. It was amazing. Not only did we have tons of family here staying with us, but we had friends around. It means the world to me. This is my absolute favorite time of year. I absolutely love it. I'm so excited that the holidays are upon us. And I just, this is just, again, my favorite time of year. I'm so incredibly blessed and thankful, not only for my friends and family, I'm thankful for my collection, and I'm also thankful to have you along this journey with me. I'm really excited that you're here. And I'm also very thankful that not only are you there in YouTube land and in the Facebook groups and everywhere else, but I'm also thankful for your honesty and your opinions. I am somebody that has trouble deciding what I wanna do or what direction I wanna go in with my collection. And I do have usually a set goal in mind, but I don't always know the best way to execute it. And right now I am in the buying mood. I am wanting to buy some things to add to this collection. I have a pretty good stockpile built up, but I've been hesitant to order because not only was I getting a new Batcave, not only were we moving, I didn't know exactly where I should go direction wise. You know, I did a video a while back about getting a whole bunch of movie busts. That is still something I would love to do. However, I don't know if it A, fits my collection, and B, where do I put them? You know, would I have to modify the way I do things? That's possible. The other way to go is to do comic book villain pieces, primarily in 1/3 scale. A lot of my friends in the collecting groups are right now collecting the samurai line from Batman. That's a line that I love as well. They're kind of going full force into it. However, that's a lot of money, and again, do I want to go that deep into something with a collection? Right now, I'm really kind of leaning more toward 1/3 scale things, like the 1/3 scale Bane, 1/3 scale Deathstroke from Prime One Studio. Those are really catching my eye here lately, especially after some in-hand photos. So it has piqued my interest, but I'm curious to know your thoughts. But the main point of this video is actually going quite a bit smaller in scale. As a lot of you know, I have these white bookshelves, and right now the bookshelves are staying. They are going to stay in my collection because I do like the look. They're also perfect for my comic book collection over here. The comic books, not only the Batman Absolutes, but also some Omnibus, some graphic novels, some hardcovers and things like that, they're going to be filling these shelves. But I also wanted to mix in some smaller scale statues as well. It doesn't really fit a Tweeterhead statue. It needs to be smaller than that. So the main things that I've been contemplating were a couple of different directions. Number one, some black and white statues, the Batman black and white. Now I know that there are over 100 of those. It's opening a can of worms for sure. They're usually $100 or less, sometimes more, sometimes less, depending on which one you're getting. And I thought maybe I would get 4, 5, or 6 and, you know, kind of mix them up in the bookshelf with my comics. Another option would be the Batman the Animated Series bust from Diamond Select. Now, these are amazing, but they are around anywhere from $30 a piece to around $50 or $60 a piece. Some of the rarer ones, like Mr. Freeze, are going for like $500. And so I'm kind of debating right now whether I should spend the money on those and collect, because again, I have that itch to collect something. I want to fill the shelf with something. You guys know how much I love Batman and his rogues. So I'm really contemplating, especially that Batman the Animated Series bust line. Some of the rare pieces are going to be difficult to find. Do I spend that money? Or should, I mean, let's say I spent $500 or $600 on those. Should I have spent the $500 and $600 on putting it toward the 1/3 scale Deathstroke? These are the type of questions that unfortunately keep me up at night. I know, real world problems, right? Real collector problems. But again, these are things that I think about. Sometimes collecting is not only about just getting it in, but it's also the hunt. And I know that the Batman the Animated Series line would be challenging to track them all down. But again, it's expensive. So what I want to do is I want to show you my bookshelf as is and kind of give you an idea of what it could look like. And I'm really curious as to know what you think I should do with the direction of these shelves. Because there's a lot of possibilities, but I definitely want your input. It means the world to me. Let's check them out.
All right, guys, so here is my current setup with my bookshelves. As you can see, again, it's still a mess in here. I'm just trying to kind of figure out exactly what I want to do. Here you can see I have my collection of absolutes and my few omnibuses that I have. Also some of my hardcovers and things like that. Again, I'm not exactly sure what I want to do, but as I mentioned before, I could potentially display my things on my bookshelves with these books here. If I got a couple of those, I like the idea of possibly having some of those. But at the same time, I was thinking of, well, should I do my black and whites and or the Diamond Select line, the Batman the Animated Series line? Obviously, the Batman the Animated Series line is going to have more color. It's going to provide more color on the shelves. I can fill the entire line with this top row, as you can see right here. Or I could do comics. I could do comics on the second row or the third row. I'm also hoping to put lighting along the top of each one of these. Try to figure that all out. And then again, I have that whole other side over there to play around with. So, budget-wise right now, I can't do both. I can't do black and whites and the animated series line. But I'm curious as to what you think. Do you think that I should collect one or the other? Do you think this is a good idea to put these mixed in with the comics, or just put statues on the top, maybe comics on the second row? I really want to know what you think. Again, I've got lots of room to expand as the comic collection grows, but at the same time, I'm just trying to figure out my direction of what I should do with these bookshelves. So definitely leave your thoughts down below, because I'd love to read them. What do you think I should do with this space?
All right, guys, so there you have it. I hope you give me some good advice here, because I definitely need it. I want this Batcave to be amazing. I want it to be colorful and be surrounded by pieces that I really enjoy. Again, I really want to know your thoughts. Should I spend the money on these smaller scale pieces, or should I just focus my money on filling that bookshelf with comics like Absolutes and Omnibus? The problem with DC stuff is there's just not as many Omnibus and Absolutes, because I don't want to collect outside of Batman. I don't want Superman Absolutes or whatever else they do. I definitely want just Batman things. So I know that I won't be able to completely fill these shelves with just comics, but there's, again, a lot of things that I could incorporate into these shelves. I want to know your opinion. Should I spend the money? Should I not? Should I just put the money toward a bigger scale statue? Because that's, I know that's what I love, and I know you guys want to see them as well. So definitely leave your thoughts down below. I want to read each and every one of them. I will try to respond as much as I can to as many of them I can, because I love to do that. So anyway, as always, guys, thank you so very much for watching. If you're new here, please hit that subscribe button. And also, if you want to take it a step further, hit that notification bell. It does hopefully notify you, again, with YouTube's analytics right now, who knows? But it does notify you, hopefully, every time I post a new video. Also, hit that like button. That does help people just like you find content just like this. And again, it means the world to me. As always, thank you so very much for watching this brief statue chat. Please like, comment, and subscribe. And as always, I'll see you right here in the Batcave. Bye, everybody.